Hi, my name is Rajen Sheth, and I'm a product manager for Google Apps at Google. And today I'm going to take you through a tour of Google Apps, which is our suite of collaboration and communications products to make teams and organizations more productive. So Google Apps provides you a variety of tools, starting with a personalized start page and going through a set of communications tools such as mail and calendar, and then also providing a set of collaborations tools such as the ability to collaborate and communicate on documents. And the idea is to take a variety of Google's tools that we provide to consumers and bring it to a setting in which organizations can use it within their organization, but hosted by Google. So I'm going to take you through what the experience is like here and the types of things that help make users more and more productive. So the user experience starts out here with the personalized start page. And with this page, there are a few things that are very unique about it. So first of all, it's essentially a portal that users really will want to use and something that people will want to come back to. And so it gives the organization the ability to customize the page. So you can see that here with, for example, the header that's customized for this organization. But critical to this is that it also gives the user the ability to personalize this page to their taste and bring in the information that they want to see and really make this their dashboard for information. So for example, I as a user can see everything from my personal work information, such as my email or my agenda for today, to my corporate information, such as integration to my news for the corporation or integration to my customer accounts. And finally, we have over 5,000 of these Google gadgets that are out there that you can bring in that provide a variety of different types of information that will help you during the workday. And so I as a user can, for example, very quickly reorient the page and drag things around to make this personalized to my taste. And in addition to that, actually add content onto this page. So my company or my organization can actually provide me a set of gadgets that I can bring onto this page. And then you can choose from the library of gadgets that Google provides that will give you a variety of tools that will help make you more productive and keep you more informed. So from here, then, this is the jumping off point where I can jump into the collaboration and communications tools. So I'm going to jump into email. So with email, what we're recognizing is that email is really where collaboration starts. Collaboration really starts where people communicate. And so what we've focused on here is not essentially trying to take people out of the inbox, but make the inbox better and better so that it is a more useful tool for users. So I want to highlight a few of the things that we've done here to make this very useful. So first of all, you can notice here that the quota is extremely large. So with the Google Apps Premier Edition, we provide a 10 gigabyte quota for your mail, which lets you preserve, you know, years upon years of email within this inbox. So what this lets you do is really make email a very, very useful tool. Now the thing is though, once you have a lot of this information within your inbox, you also want to be able to find it very, very quickly. So we provide very, very fast sub-second response Google search in order to allow you to find that information at your fingertips. So you could have literally gigabytes worth of email within this inbox, but find it with just the click of a search button here. In addition to this, we provide a variety of tools within the inbox that make you more productive. So, for example, here, you can see that this user just got an email from a sales rep, and it's a very actionable email that she needs to respond to very, very quickly. So we provide a variety of ways that she can actually get back to the sales rep on this particular topic. So you can see that he's actually looking for the status of a particular product. Now I can see here that this user, Jason Jones, is actually online by looking at the green dot. And so as a result of that, we can actually type an instant message and actually talk to the user right here. So I'm going to tell Jason here that we'll get back to him very quickly on the status so that Jason knows that that's the case. The thing to notice here is that this is all within a web browser, so it doesn't involve any other applications. I can access this and access the full range of tools from any computer anywhere that's connected to the internet, and it gives me a very rich experience regardless of where I am. So the other thing here is that Jason is asking if this is a meeting that we can make. So we provide tools to allow the user to essentially add this to the calendar. And so what we do here is interpret particular parts of the message to give the user the right tools that they need. So here we interpreted that there's a meeting with Hestia, and it's next Friday. And so based on the date of the message, we interpret exactly what next Friday is and give you the option to add this to the calendar. These are just a few of the examples of the tools that we integrate. So at this point, we want to actually get back to Jason about the status of this particular project. So I'm going to type in Project Orion Dashboard. And sure enough, I find an email where this was being discussed. So I'll go into this email. Now, this email is a very typical email of what you might see within a corporation. And a few things to note here. So first of all, it's a very, very long thread. There are many people that have responded to this. So what we do is actually capture this within a conversation. And we have this stacked card view, which will let you see all of the conversations very, very easily, and initially see a summary of the conversation, and then be able to click and actually see the entire message, and that particular message. The second thing to note here is that this is a typical conversation where a document has been attached. And then this document is subsequently edited by many users who proceed to make their changes and attach their own version of the document. Now the problem is that you end up with 6 copies of this document, each with their own changes, and you'll have to actually reconcile all of the changes manually. So this is where we bring in Google Docs and Spreadsheets. And Google Docs and Spreadsheets provide you with a tool to allow you to collaborate on documents more and more efficiently. So you can see in this particular thread, Mary has actually gone ahead and created a Google spreadsheet, and this allows everybody to be on the same page with that particular spreadsheet. So let me show you what this spreadsheet looks like in Google Docs and Spreadsheets. So this is what the Project Orion dashboard looks like, and you can see that it's essentially a shared dashboard that tracks the project status. And it's a very, very familiar user interface where you have the same kinds of capabilities that you would expect within a spreadsheet program. But it adds the collaborative capabilities that spreadsheet programs don't provide. So while I'm editing this document and changing, for example, changing the status of a project, other people can be editing the document at the same time and updating their status as well. And as I'm changing this, I can see other changes happen while this is going on. In addition, I can actually then discuss these changes with whoever is looking at the spreadsheet right now at this time. And then I can also collaborate. Now, this allows me to give fine-grained control over who can edit the document and who can see the document, and this can change over time. And then basically any of the collaborators will then be able to come in and make their changes in the document and get everybody on the same page. Now, one thing that's very critical here is that if you have multiple people making changes to the same document at the same time, you want to be able to see what changes were made. So we provide a revisions capability. So with the revisions feature, you can actually step back through time and see the changes that were made at a variety of points during the document's lifecycle. And then you can actually step back and revert to any of these versions of the document at any particular time. So we also offer a product called Google Docs, which does the same thing for documents. And so we provide the ability here to allow you to edit a document and provide you the same types of rich rich editing capabilities that you would typically expect out of a word processor. Things like, for example, the ability to have formatting. Things like the ability to comment on particular types of particular areas of the document. Also, the ability to do things like editing tables or adding images to the document. But then, as with Google Spreadsheets, you have the ability to collaborate on this. So you're able to add people that you want to collaborate on the document with. And then you can keep track of revisions. So I can go back and actually look at what revisions were made in this particular document. So I can see, for example, who made what change in this document at what time, and then step back through any of the documents and see what changes were made within this particular document. So here I can see, for example, that Cyrus added these two lines and then subtracted this line about 3 weeks ago in this particular document. This is a powerful tool that allows multiple people to write a document and compose a document at the same time. Now, once you're done with collaborating on a document, the other part is how do you get this information out to all of your users and how do you publish this? So we provide you a variety of ways of publishing the document. So we allow you to essentially save this document in a variety of formats. You can save it as HTML, but you can also save it in a variety of Office formats and as PDF as well. And then, in addition to that, if you just want to publish this internally to your company via the web, you can actually just click this link and actually publish the document to your corporation. So going back to this message, the other thing that I needed to do is actually add something to my calendar. So Google Apps provides users a calendar by which they can not only keep track of their agenda, but in addition to that, they can collaborate with other users very easily and bring in more and more information. So extending the capabilities of calendar to make it more of a collaborative medium. So a few things to note on this calendar. So we provide a lot of the same functionality that you would typically expect with a calendar. So you can very easily create a meeting by just adding this to your calendar. You can also drag this meeting around to another point on your calendar. You can extend it such that if you want to have more time for the meeting, you can make it a longer meeting or make it shorter. But we've also added a variety of features here that make it more collaborative. So the first thing is that I can very easily create a shared calendar. So all I need to do is click on the plus link here and create a project calendar, for example. Now this is then a shared calendar that I can then add a variety of tasks to and then share out with anybody within my company. And they can then overlay this on top of their calendar. Now when I go and I create an event, I have a choice. I can actually put this on my personal calendar or I can put this on any of the shared calendars that I have. So you can see then when I bring in one of the shared calendars, what it does is it actually overlays the events on top of my calendar in a different color. So I can clearly see what events are part of the Project Orion product calendar. In addition to having these shared calendars within your organization, you can bring in other calendars from either within your organization or from outside your organization. So for example, here's a calendar that a partner has shared in with me. So I can actually bring this in to my calendar and actually see what my partner's schedule is in terms of free and busy information. So I can very quickly schedule a meeting with a partner. But in addition to that, we have indexed a variety of calendars out there and provide you the ability to add these calendars onto your personal calendar. So for example, if you want to keep track of events within the industry, you can look up particular events and particular calendars that relate to your particular industry and add that to your calendar. In addition, for example, if I wanted to put on if I wanted to add calendars of personal interest. So, for example, the NCAA tournament. I can actually find what the calendar is for the NCAA basketball tournament and add this to my calendar. Now, this is actually a live calendar. Now, when I go back to my calendar, you can actually see within this that we've added in the particular the games that will happen for this particular tournament. And this gets updated in real time so that you're able to see any changes that happen to this particular calendar. So this is the basics of the user experience. It provides you all of the tools you need in your everyday life to collaborate with your coworkers and to bring in information that you need. So the other part is we want to make this very, very simple for the administrator of the IT administrator of a corporation to very easily deploy to their users. So what we do is we allow you to very quickly sign up for this on the web. So you can go through a very simple sign-up flow and actually sign up for this service and be up and running within less than a minute. Now, within here, you can then essentially choose the services that you want to deploy to your users and activate those services. So from this web-based dashboard, you can see the services that you've activated, and you can see status about the various users that you might have on the system. So you'll see a dashboard to see the kind of activity that you have on the system. You can then go into the various user accounts and actually see within here who your users are and actually manage your users. So I can go in, for example, here and change the password of the user, suspend the user, delete the user, do a variety of tasks that you would typically want to do with the users on your messaging and collaboration system. We give you a variety of abilities to customize this domain as well. So we let you, for example, swap out the logo on each of the applications and put in your own logo. You have the choice with the premium edition with the premier edition of Google Apps to hide advertising and display either display or not display advertising. And you also have a variety of information about your account, including the ability to dial and call in to support if you ever need any help with any issues. Also, for each of the various applications, we give you the ability to set policies. So for example, within something like Google Docs and Spreadsheets, you may want to restrict the ability to send documents outside of your organization. So we give you the ability to say whether or not users can share documents outside of the organization, and if they do, to warn them and let them know that they're sharing something outside of the company. And we provide a variety of settings similarly for a variety of the other applications here. So in conclusion, really what we're driving towards here is providing the end user very simple, very easy to use tools that will make them more and more productive within the workday, and providing the IT administrator a very simple tool to be able to deploy these services to the organization without much hassle. And as a result of that, make both the IT department as well as your users more and more productive.